You've slept with like 200 women and you're not even 30. I'm just like, does your willy ever stay in your trousers? Like, do you just walk around with your willy just hanging out?
Hi, my name's Amina and this is my 16-year-old daughter.
Hi, my name's Natania.
And this is Sex Drive.
You know, I've been single for so long, and I'm not. You've never actually seen me in a relationship.
I know. I don't know if I'll be able to imagine it. I don't know.
The other day you were saying, "Oh, mom, I don't think." Would you say that I need to wait until you move out before I can be in a relationship?
Yeah, you can't be having people kissing someone and then I'm here. Like, no, you have to wait till I leave. No.
What?
You have to wait until I leave. I can't. I actually can't. There's no way.
Why not? I think it's healthy to see that kind of stuff. Like,
mom,
you know? You
haven't been with anyone for my whole entire life. I don't even remember you and my dad being together and you expect me to just accept you with some random.
It's not going to be random. Obviously, you're going to get a chance to know the person and get to know them and. You know, develop your own relationship with them. So it's not gonna, I'm not gonna like just bring home some random dude and be like, oh yeah, by the way, I'm going out with this guy. This is my boyfriend.
I know, but I don't wanna see that. So you have to wait until I leave the house.
But do you not wanna see it because it's cringe or do you not wanna see it because it's cringe?
The first one.
Guys approaching you. To wanna get to an area.
Yeah.
What do you do in those situations?
I remember one time I was in Romford in the shoe shop and then some guy came up to me like asking like to get my number and stuff like that. And then obviously to me, I don't know if this is another thing. In my generation, it's weird to ask for someone's number because it's more ask for their Snapchat, ask for their Instagram. It wouldn't be can I get your number? It's just not like that in our generation.
Meanwhile, I am scared to give a guy my number. I'm more like, follow me on Instagram.
Yeah. So when I think I just know how to turn a guy down at this point because I'd be like,
so wait, he was like, can I have your number?
And yeah,
he was
and
like,
also he was shorter than me. I was like, okay, no. So like, he used to be asking like, can I get your number? I was like, no, but and he kept on trying, and he was like, what about your Instagram? And I was like, yeah, you can follow me on Instagram. He gets out his phone and searches my Instagram, starts scrolling through my Instagram right in front of me.
Oh my god,
I was like,
that is so awkward.
I know, like that's not what you do. And then I saw him follow me in front of me, and he's just scrolling through, and he's like, these are nice
pictures.
But
other than the fact that he was short, was he paying?
No.
Okay. One time, this is not in person though, this is on a dating app, and the guy was asking me the most random things, like, what would you do if your boyfriend had erectile dysfunction?
What?
Do you know what that is?
Yeah, when they can't.
How do you know what that is? How the hell do you know what that is?
I don't know. I just know what it is.
Wait, because the name of it sounds like you can make it out.
No, I feel like I've Googled it before.
You Googled erectile dysfunction?
I don't know why. I just remember Googling it and it telling me where it is.
Maybe did someone say it in the show or something?
I don't know.
Woke up one day and said, let me Google erectile dysfunction.
I can't remember, but I just know I found out from Google. That's how you find out a lot of things in my era, from Google.
To me, how it comes across from my perspective, I feel like everyone's having sex. Like, all the young people are having sex. Like, a lot of stuff that we see is encouraging young people to explore their sexuality and, be free, having more confidence in, being sexual and doing whatever it is that you feel that you want to do and having control over yourself in the sense that, if you want to have 10 one-night stands, you can have 10 one-night stands. Like, if you want to sleep with every Tom, Dick and Harry, be free. Do what you want to do.
People are still free. Like, people my age still definitely go have sex, do stuff with boys.
Yeah.
But it's just that you wouldn't be proud to tell everyone, I've done that. It's more like if you've done that, people
do it behind
judge
closed
you.
Doors.
Yeah. If a girl is known to have a high body count, people look at her like she's a hoe and stuff like that. Which, I mean, I feel like that's probably the reason why I haven't felt pressured to have sex.
Yeah.
Because there's no pressure.
I don't know if I would ask a guy, what's your body count? Because I don't know if... I don't know how that would come up in a conversation, because I definitely wouldn't ask that.
In my age, in my generation, that is like such a common question. Oh, what's your body count? What's the most you've done with a guy? Like, boys ask that straight
really?
Up.
Really? Even when they're about to like be a, like ask the girl to be their girlfriend?
Wait, that would be like one of the first questions.
Really?
Yes, like in my era, that's such a big thing. Because the thing, but the thing is, yeah, boys, for them, they can just go sleep with whoever they want. They can have a high body count. No one
and it's
care.
Their praise for it.
Yeah. But then with girls, they always say, oh, I don't want a girl that has a body count more than three. But then,
which doesn't make sense. Yeah, because you yourself, are all these girls that you're sleeping with that you're adding to your body count. Clearly, yeah. Like, it takes two to, like, have sex.
I remember that's happened to me before. Like,
someone asked you, what's your body count?
Yeah, what's the most you've done with a boy? All of that stuff.
What?
And I'm just like,
first of all, mind your business. That's personal.
It's literally like, not. Like, at this point,
really, it's not a personal thing.
It's not a personal thing.
Really? People just put it out there, like,
I think it's to the point where a lot of girls lie about their body count.
Oh.
So a lot of girls will say that their body count is three because that's an acceptable number, apparently. Like, people have decided that three is an acceptable number.
Okay.
So then if their body count is more than three, they'll have to say it's three in fear of being rejected because of the
fact
that...
So they can't even say four or three and a half.
I don't know, but I just know that three is like a calm number, like
at 16.
Yeah.
Three at 16. Like, obviously, having a mum who's celibate, and I talk about my celibacy a lot, as you know, and you know, I've kind of explained to you why I'm celibate in terms of the reasoning why I'm doing it and what I believe. And obviously you're getting to an age now where you've got your own, you've always had your own kind of mind, and I think you're like really mature in that sense where, I mean, when you say that you don't feel pressure because, you know, you're going to do whatever you want to do, you're not going to do something because someone else is doing it, I believe that because I can sense that, you know, you're very, you have your own mind in a sense about a lot of things. So although I've expressed like, this is my celibacy, this is why I'm doing it, yada yada yada, I just want to know like what you genuinely feel, not just because me as your mum, this is what I said is the case. I think I would really like to know like what you genuinely feel about it, and if it's something that you would consider doing, or if you think, if you would call yourself celibate.
For me, I just feel like I'm young and all celibacy stuff seems like adult like stuff. Like, I feel like for me, I just feel like I don't have to make that decision yet. Like, I feel like because I don't know how to explain it. If I was in the dating scene, then I feel like it would make sense for me to claim whether I'm celibate or not, because I would need, that would be an important thing.
Yeah.
Because I'm just living my life, I don't think about sex, I don't think about none of that, so I never thought to claim that I'm celibate.
Right.
I feel like losing your virginity is less of a big deal nowadays. Not as in less of a big deal in terms of like, oh, do I really want to do this? Like, oh,
Do I want to wait? Yeah.
I feel like people say, yeah, oh well, like I like
it's
this.
Happened.
I like this guy.
I'm gonna do it with him, and we're just gonna do it.
Yeah, like I feel like,
It doesn't have that much like deeper
meaning.
Meaning, yeah. It's just sex.